back, and it's time now for our monthly Fort Polk segment. With me now is a Command Sergeant Major David W. Bass, who is the Command Sergeant Major for JRTC in Fort Polk. Going to tell us about the JRTC in Fort Polk box tour, what it's all about. So, David, welcome. Good
yes,
to have
sir.
You.
Good to be here.
First, you know, we were just briefly talking about your background a little bit. You're from Georgia.
Yes, sir. From originally born and raised in South Georgia, mm-hmm. a small farming town called Ashburn. I'm fluent in small town southern living.
And you've been at Fort Polk now for a few years.
Yes, sir. 3.5 years. I had the honor and privilege of coming here initially to be the operations group command sergeant major.
Okay.
Very prestigious position on Fort Polk. And then after about 17 months, I had the opportunity to interview with the commanding general at the time, Major General Brito, who mm-hmm. selected me to be the post command sergeant major. And I've been serving in that position now with Brigadier General Frank for about 2 years now.
Yeah, a lot of responsibility.
Huge responsibility for our Army. We train about a third of the infantry brigade combat teams a year, mm-hmm. 11 rotations a year, anywhere from $30 to $35 million of our taxpayers' money in ensuring readiness for our Army.
I got you. All yes, right. Sir. Tell me about the box tour. What
well, the box
about.
Tour is a great event. We have not held it for a little while now, and the Commanding General General Frank had put it off intentionally a little bit to he wanted to maximize the opportunity for folks to come out and be able to participate and see this, mm-hmm. and we're expanding it a little bit.
Yeah, you were talking about that a minute ago.
So what we do at JRTC is we train infantry brigade combat teams
right.
for a go-to-war mission in the hopes that we never have to send our soldiers to war. They deploy to Fort Polk as if they're coming to another country, mm-hmm. And they build combat power, and then they go into a fictional country, liberate that country mm-hmm. over a 14-day training
period.
I think
we have some pictures of what people will see.
Yes, sir. So what we're going to demonstrate are some of the things that goes on in the box.
Okay.
So we have small cities or villages out in the box. We're going to put on a demonstration where our tenant unit, 3rd Brigade, 10th Mountain mm-hmm. Patriots are going to have the good guys are going to fight the bad guys, uh-huh. the opposing force, our world-class opposing force, the Geronimo Battalion. And we're going to demonstrate that in one of the towns. Shugar Gordon, as some know it to be. It's also called Singari in the fictional role. That demonstration, power techniques, bombs, bullets,
yeah.
sounds, smells of the
battlefield. Try to make it as realistic as possible.
Try to make it as real as possible without yeah. firing real live bullets at soldiers.
Gotcha. Okay, and people can come watch this. Guests can come.
Yes, sir.
How you register?
Well, you go to eventbrite.com,
yeah.
And we understand it, the registration, the CG found out a few days ago that we had maxed out the registration. So mm-hmm. he went to our folks and he said, okay, I want to open it up to more people. And we've gone through that process, and you can go on eventbrite.com, register, come out on Saturday. We're going to take you out to one of the villages, and then the part of the expansion for this event is from the village and seeing that demonstration, we're going to take you out to a larger village out on Geronimo Drop Zone, famous part of the battlefield, mm-hmm. and folks are going to see soldiers jump out of a perfectly good airplane. So it's going to be a great event.
Which some people might think is a little crazy, but
maybe, but it's part of readiness, and
right.
We're going to demonstrate for the public what the Joint Readiness Training Center does for our
Should
soldiers.
Be fascinating to watch.
It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, how long will it the tour take place?
I believe you start out at 8 in the morning with a briefing.
Mm-hmm.
From there, the short video, and then we'll get on buses about... I think by the end of the day, we get on buses around 9 o'clock, and by mm-hmm. the end of the day, probably back about 1500 in the afternoon, 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Right, got yes, it. Sir. David, thanks for coming. Again, register on of you. There's still spots open.
Yes, sir.
Eventbrite.com.
Yes, sir. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thanks for dropping by.
All right.
We have more to come on this Tuesday. We're going to tell you about the Joan Cathy Dance Center Stars. That is over in Leesville, and Quincy Vadreen has a lunch and learn that's coming up.